It is time to take a look at what Pure is up to from a slightly different perspective. To help us do that is Scott Sinclair, who is a senior analyst at the Enterprise Strategy Group. And Scott, thanks for joining us here on theCUBE. Good to see you today.
Great to see you.
All right, so let's jump into this. First, we'll get to the announcement just a little bit. First off, in terms of Pure's strategy, as you've been watching this company evolve over years now, how has it evolved? And then we'll move to the announcements and how that fits into the strategy. But first off, let's just take them from your point of view. Where have they been and how are they doing?
Yeah, you know, many people know of Pure, maybe they don't know, of their history as an all-flash array. I think Pure has always been, ever since they entered the IT industry, as a pioneer. They're one of the early ones that said, look, we're going all in on the all-flash array business and a focus on flash technology. Then there were early pioneers in things like Evergreen and things like storage as a service capabilities for on-premises storage. And the entire time they've had a really, you know, almost streamlined focus on ease of use, which, you know, from the outside, I think everyone talks about ease of use and making things simple for IT, but Pure has really made that almost like core as part of not only their product and their design, but also part of their culture. And one of the things, and we'll get into this a little bit as we talk about the announcements, but, you know, if you look at these announcements and where Pure's going, they're trying to expand that culture, that DNA around ease of use or simplicity, and expanding it beyond just storage or IT operations, and really trying to see, okay, how do we make the entire digital initiative process or the larger IT operations journey simpler? And I think that's part of where Pure is going. Is not just storage, but focusing more on apps, operations, and data, and making it easier for the entire experience.
So how do the announcements, we're talking about, well, there are three phases here, and again, we'll unpack those separately, but just in general, now, how do the announcements then, you think, fit into that strategy and fit into their view, and your view, really, of the market trends?
You know, I think one of the big trends is, you know, IT, in terms for, you know, most businesses, is it's not just an enabler anymore. IT is actually in the driver's seat. You know, we see in our research at ESG, we just did this study, and I'm going to glance over my notes as I'm kind of talking, but we see one of the things is more than half of businesses are identifying some portion of their revenue is coming from digital products or digital services. So data is part of the revenue chain for a majority of organizations, according to what we're seeing in our research. And so what that does is it puts IT right in that core, you know, that core delivery model of where the faster IT can operate, the faster organizations can realize these revenue opportunities. So what is that doing to IT organizations? Well, first off, it makes their life a lot harder. It makes demands continue to increase. But also this old adage or this old narrative that IT is about availability, it's about resiliency, it's about keeping the lights on and ensuring that the business doesn't go down. Well, none of that goes away, but now IT organizations are being measured on their ability to accelerate operations. And in this world where everything's becoming more, you know, more complex, there are more demands, organizations are becoming more distributed, application demands are becoming more diverse, and they're growing in breadth. All of this means that more pressure is falling not only on the IT operations, but also on the infrastructure providers like Pure Storage to step up and make things even simpler with things like automation and simplification, which, you know, again, we're going to talk about, but to help accelerate those operations.
Yeah, I mean, if you're DevOps these days, I mean, you're talking about kind of these quandaries that people are in. But I mean, what are these specific challenges, do you think? I mean, on the enterprise level here, that Pure is addressing.
Yeah, well, so for example, you talked about developers and, you know, driving into, you know, that in particular. I want to say, let's see, you know, glancing at my notes here. About two-thirds of organizations say they're under pressure to accelerate their IT initiatives due to pressures specifically from DevOps teams as well as line of business teams. So what does that mean? It means that as organizations build up and try to accelerate either their revenue creation via the creation of software or products or things that drive, that support a DevOps team. Maybe it's improving customer experience, for example, as well as other line of business teams, such as analytics and trying to provide better insights and better decision-making off of data. What that means is this traditional process of IT operations of where you submit a trouble ticket and then it takes, you know, after a few days, something happens and they start doing analysis in terms of basically what ends up being multiple days or multiple weeks to end up to basically provision storage just takes too long. And so in these announcements, what we're seeing is pure delivering solutions that are all about automating the backend services and delivering storage in a way that is designed to be easily and quickly consumed by the new consumers of IT, the developers, the line of business teams, via APIs, where you can write to a standard API and it goes across basically lots of different technologies and happens very quickly, where a lot of the backend processes are automated and essentially making the storage invisible to these new consumers. And all of that just delivers value because what these groups are doing is now they can access and get the resources that they need, and they don't have to know about what's happening behind the scenes, which, you know, candidly, they don't really know much about right now, and they don't really care.
Right. That's right. Yeah, what I don't see, what I don't know won't hurt me.
Exactly.
But it can, as we know, it can. All right, so let's look at the announcements. Pure Fusion. I think we were hearing about that just a little bit before earlier in the interview that Dave was conducting, but let's talk about Pure Fusion and your thoughts on that.
Yeah, Pure Fusion is what I was talking about a little bit, where they're abstracting a lot of the storage capabilities and presenting it as an API, a consistent API that allows developers to provision things very quickly, and where a lot of the backend services are automated and, you know, essentially invisible to the developer. And that is, I mean, it addresses where, you know, I kind of talked about this with some of the data that we just, you know, some of our research stats that we just discussed, but it's where a lot of organizations are going. The bottom line is, you know, we used to, you know, in a world where IT services weren't growing as fast and where everything had to be resilient and available, you could put a lot of personnel power or personnel hours focused on, okay, making sure every box and everything was checked prior to doing a new implementation. And all that was designed to reduce risk and possibly optimize the environment, reduce cost. Now in this world of acceleration, what we've seen is organizations need faster responsiveness from their IT organization. Well, that's all well and good, but the problem is it's difficult to do all those back-end processes and make sure that data is fully being protected or making sure that everything is happening behind the scenes the way it should be. And so this is, again, just mounting more and more pressure. So with things like Pure Fusion, what they're doing is they're essentially automating a lot of that on the back end and really simplifying it and making it so storage or IT administrators can provide access to their line of business, to development teams, to leverage infrastructure a lot faster while still ensuring that all those back end services, all those operations still happen.
Portworx Data Services also announced, and hearing from Dave, from that perspective, maybe a game changer in terms of storage. So your take on that, on Portworx?
You know, I really like Portworx. I've been following them ever since prior to the acquisition. You know, one of the things that they were very early on is understanding the impact of microservices on the industry and really the importance of designing infrastructure around for that environment. I think what they're doing around data services is really intriguing. I think it's really intriguing, first off, for Pure as a company, because it elevates their visibility to a new audience and a new persona that may not have been familiar with them, right? As organizations are looking at, you know, one of the things that they're doing with this data services is essentially delivering a database as a service platform where you can go provision, you know, and stand up databases very quickly. And again, similar to what we talked about Fusion, a lot of those back-end processes are automated. Really fascinating, again, aligns directly with this acceleration need that we talked about. So, you know, huge value, but it's really fascinating for Pure because it opens him up to, you know, hey, there's this whole new world of possible consumers that where there's, you know, it's that where they can get experience to really the ease of use of Pure is known for, a lot of the capabilities of Portworx is known for, but also just, you know, increase, you know, really the value that Pure is able to deliver to some of these modern enterprises.
And just briefly on the enhancements to Pure One also being announced today, your take on those?
You know, I like that as well. I think one of the things, if I kind of go through the list, is a lot of insights and intelligence in terms of new app, you know, sizing applications for the environment, if I remember correctly, and more, you know, better capabilities to help ensure that your environment is optimized, which candidly is a top challenge around IT organizations. We talk about, again, I keep hitting on this need to move faster, faster, faster. One of the big disconnects that we've seen, and we saw it very early when organizations were moving to, for example, public cloud services, is this disconnect towards, for this individual app, how many resources do I really need? And I think that's something that, you know, vendors like Pure need to start integrating more and more intelligence. And that's what my understanding is they're doing with Pure One, which is really impressive.
Well, solid takes. Scott, we appreciate the time. Thank you for your insights and what has been a big day for Pure Storage. But thank you again for the time. Scott Sinclair at the Enterprise Strategy Group, senior analyst there. Let's go back to Dave Vellante now with more on theCUBE.
Thanks for watching this CUBE program made possible by Pure Storage. I want to say in summary, you know, sometimes it's hard to squint through all the vendor noise on cloud and as a service and all the buzzwords and acronyms in the marketplace. But as we said at the top, the cloud is changing, it's evolving, it's expanding to new locations. The operating model is increasingly defining the cloud. There's so much opportunity to build value on top of the massive infrastructure build-out from the hyperscalers, $100 billion in CapEx last year alone. This is not just true for technology vendors, but organizations are building their own layer to take advantage of the cloud. Now, of course, technology is critical. So when you're evaluating technology solutions, look for the following. First, the ability of the solution to simplify your life. Can it abstract the underlying complexity of a cloud, multiple clouds, connect to on-prem workloads in an experience that is substantially identical, irrespective of location? Does the solution leverage cloud-native technologies and innovations and primitives and APIs, or is it just a hosted stack that's really not on the latest technology curve, whether that's processor technology or virtualization or machine learning, streaming, open source tech, et cetera? Third, how programmable is the infrastructure? Does it make developers more productive? Does it accelerate time to value? Does it minimize rework and increase the quality of your output? Four, what's the business impact? Will customers stand up and talk about the solution and how it contributed to their digital transformation? By flexibly supporting emerging data-intensive workloads and evolving as their business rapidly changed. These are some of the important markers that we would suggest you monitor. Pure is obviously driving hard to optimize these and other areas, so watch closely and make your own assessment as to how what they and others are building will fit into your business. Now, as always, this content is available on demand at thecube.net, so definitely check that out. This is Dave Vellante for John Walls and the entire CUBE team. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.